Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss practice questions related to conditional programming in QBasic. Previously I have created 3 videos in which I have explained conditional programming in QBasic using if-else and select case. So you can go to my channel, click on the class 8 playlist and there you will find all 3 videos. If you have not seen those videos, then you watch those videos first and then you come back to this video. First question, write a program in QBasic to accept 3 numbers, then find the second greatest number between them. Sample input, suppose the numbers are 15, 7 and 12, then the output should come 12, because 12 is the second greatest number between 15, 7 and 12. Let's begin with the program. CLS, input, enter 3 numbers. We can take the variable A, B and C. The condition will be if A is greater than B and A is less than C, or A is less than B and A is greater than C, then print second greatest is A. Else if B is greater than A and B is less than C, or B is less than A and B is greater than C, then print second greatest is B. Else if C is greater than A and C is less than B, or C is less than A and C is greater than B, then print second greatest is C. Else print two or more same. End if end. So there will be 2 set of conditions inside of every if block. Now if A is greater than B and A is less than C, that is the first condition. Or if A is less than B and A is greater than C, that is the second condition. If any one of the condition is true, means either A is greater than B and A is less than C, so A is the second greatest. Otherwise, if A is less than B and A is greater than C, then also A is the second greatest. Either the left side condition or the right side condition should be true, then A is second greatest. Similarly, if the first condition is false, it will go to the second one and there we are checking for B. If B is greater than A and B is less than C, then B is second greatest. Otherwise, if B is less than A and B is greater than C, then also B is the second greatest. Similarly, we are checking for C, and if all 3 conditions are false, then it will go to else and there it will print 2 or more same. Okay. Let's execute the program. Enter 3 numbers. Suppose the first number is 15, comma, second number is 7, comma, third number is 12. I will press enter. The second greatest is 12. Second question. Write a program in QBasic to accept 3 sides, then check if triangle formation is possible or not. If possible, then also check whether it is equilateral, isosceles or scalene triangle. Now, how we can conclude that the triangle formation is possible? The condition is the sum of any 2 sides should be greater than the third side. That means A plus B should be greater than B and B plus C should be greater than A and A plus C should be greater than B. Then we can say that triangle formation is possible, else we can say it is not possible. Now, if the triangle formation is possible, then we also have to check the type of triangle. It can be equilateral, it can be isosceles, it can be scalene triangle. So, if all three sides are same, then equilateral triangle. If any two sides are same, then isosceles triangle. If all three sides are different, then it is scalene triangle. So, let's begin with the program. CLS, input, enter three sides. We can have ABC. First condition, if A plus B is greater than C and A plus C is greater than B and B plus C is greater than A, then print triangle formation is possible. Now, if triangle formation is possible, we also have to check the type of triangle. So, there will be another if inside of this first if, okay? There we write if A is equal to B and A is equal to C, then print equilateral triangle. Else if A is equal to B or A is equal to C or B is equal to C, then it is isosceles triangle. Else it is scalene triangle. Okay, now I will be writing end if. This end if is for the inner if, okay? The end if that I have just given, this is for the inner if. The outer if is still open. For that, I need to write the else part. So, else print triangle formation is not possible. Okay? Then I write end if again and I write end. So, the first condition is for the triangle formation check, okay? If the first condition is false, then it will directly go to else part and it will print triangle formation is not possible. That means if the triangle cannot be formed, you are not going to check which type of triangle it is, okay? So, if the condition is false, directly print triangle formation is not possible. Now, if the triangle formation is possible, then it will go inside the first condition, print triangle formation is possible, then also check which type of triangle it is. So, if A is equal to B and A is equal to C, that means all three sides are same, it will print equilateral triangle. If A is equal to B, otherwise B is equal to C, otherwise A equal to C, then it will print isosceles triangle, means any two sides are same, and else it will print scalene triangle if all three sides are different. Okay, you don't need to write the third condition. If the first two conditions are wrong, that means it is scalene only. Let's see the output of this program. Okay, it is asking for three sides. Suppose the sides are 25, 50 and 16. So, triangle formation is possible and it is scalene triangle. Third question. Write a program in QBasic to accept the type of stream S for science, C for commerce, A for arts. So we have to take input string because S, C, A, these are string values. And we also have to take input the percentage marks. And according to the given condition, we have to display a message that if admission is possible or not. Like if the user is entering S and the minimum marks is 85, as we can see. So if the percentage marks is below 85, then it will print admission not possible, and if it is greater than or equal to 85, it will print admission is possible. Similarly, if the user is entering the stream A for arts, then if the percentage is greater than or equal to 40, it will print admission is possible. If it is below 40, it will print admission is not possible. Let's see the program of this one. CLS. Now we need to take input two things. First is the stream, second is the percentage. Now for inputting string, we require a variable with a dollar sign that represents a string in QBasic. So we will write input enter stream. Okay, in bracket we can give S, comma C, comma A. Okay, where S is science, C is commerce, and A is arts. You can also write the entire message if you want, like S for science, C for commerce, A for arts, like that. And then we are taking input. So the variable we are taking here as ST for stream. Just add a dollar sign after the variable. The dollar sign represents that it is a string. Now we also have to take input the percentage marks. So we will write enter percentage. Okay. Then we can take a variable P for percentage. Now if the stream is science, then we have a different cutoff, right? So we have to write if ST dollar means the stream is equal to S. Okay, write in double quote because it is a string value. So if ST dollar means if the stream which is given by the user is equal to S, means it is science, then if percentage is greater than equal to 85, then print admission possible, else print admission not possible. Okay, and if. Now we will write else if for the outer condition. Else if ST dollar is equal to C for commerce. Okay, then another set of condition, percentage minimum should be 60. So P greater than equal to 60, then print admission possible, else print admission not possible. Okay, and if. Now we will write else part. Okay, you can also write else if, and there you mention ST dollar equal to A, that is your choice, but I am using else for that. Means if first two choices are wrong, means it is not S, it is not C, then I am assuming it will be A for arts. So in the else block, if percentage is greater than equal to 40, then print admission possible, else print admission not possible, end if, and again end if, end. Okay, so the first if block has inner if else, the second else if block also is having inner if else, the third else block is also having inner if else. If the first condition is true, means if the stream is science, then the percentage will be required 85, then admission possible, else not possible. If the stream is commerce C, then for greater than equal to 60, it will be admission possible, otherwise not possible. And for arts, greater than equal to 40 is possible admission, otherwise not possible. There are two end ifs back to back. This end if is for the inner if, and this end if is for the outer if. Let's execute the program F5. It is asking enter stream SCA. I am taking C for commerce. Enter percentage, I am taking 70. So it will display admission possible. Fourth question. Write a program in QBasic to accept the type of citizen. G for general citizen means below 60 years, and S for senior citizen, and distance to be traveled. Then calculate train fare as per the following conditions: up to 50 kilometers, rupees 100 fixed; between 51 to 100 kilometers, rupees 5 per kilometer; between 101 to 300 kilometers, rupees 8 per kilometer; between 301 to 800 kilometers, ₹10 per kilometer. More than 800 kilometers, then ₹12.5 per kilometer. And for the senior citizens, we have to give 20% discount in the total fare. Okay, that means the type of citizen which we are taking input, GNS, that is having no use in the condition part. Only after the fare is calculated, means the train fare is calculated, then only we are going to check if the type of citizen is S, means senior citizen, then we will have to give 20% discount in the total fare. Let's start the program. CLS input, enter type of citizen. In bracket we can mention G, S. Okay. Then take input. I am taking T dollar. As I told in the previous program also, dollar sign is used for strings. Because we are going to take input G and S, so they are string values. We have to use a dollar sign. One more thing we need to take input, that is the distance. Okay. So enter distance. D for distance. Now first condition, if distance is less than equal to 50, means up to 50 kilometers, then what is the fare? Fare is 100 only. So I can write F equal to 100. Else if distance is greater than equal to 51 and distance is less than equal to 100. Okay. In that case, we have ₹5 per kilometer. So I can write F equal to D into 5, means the distance multiplied by ₹5 per kilometer. Else if third condition, distance is greater than equal to 101 and distance is less than equal to 300, up to 300 kilometers, then fare is equal to ₹8 per kilometer. So we have to write D into 8. Okay. Then fourth condition, else if distance is greater than equal to 301 and distance is less than equal to 800, up to 800 kilometers, then fare is equal to D into 10 rupees per kilometer. Else last one, more than 800 kilometer. Don't write the last condition. Never write the last condition. It is in else only directly. So last one is 12.5 per kilometer. We can write F equal to D into 12.5. Then we write end if. Okay. So there are total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are total 5 conditions. Correct. First is up to 50 kilometers. Second is 51 to 100. Third is 101 to 300. Fourth is 301 to 800 and fifth is more than 800. Now my fare is calculated. Now I have to check which type of citizen the user is. It can be G or S. I will use if else condition again. I can write if T dollar, means the type of citizen, is equal to S, because we are only bothered about the senior citizen. Okay. For senior citizen, we have to give 20% discount. So I can write here, discount is equal to F into 0.20. F into 0.20 means 20% of the fare. Then the fare will be changing. So F equal to F minus DIS, the current fare minus discount. And this will only happen if the T dollar, means the type of citizen, is senior citizen. If it is general citizen, then there will be no extra allowance for that. Okay. Now we need to print the fare. So I can write fare is equal to semicolon F and end. Program is complete. Let's run the program. Output screen is here. Enter type of citizen, G or S. I am taking S as senior citizen. Enter distance, I am taking 100. So total is 500, but it will give me 20% discount. So 500, 20% is ₹100. Okay, so 500 minus 100 is 400, that is the cost. Fifth question, Write a program in QBasic to accept the number of persons and charges per person, then find out the travel charges as per the following conditions. Up to 3 persons, ₹500 per person. Between 4 to 10 person, then ₹400 per person. Between 11 to 20 persons, then ₹350 per person. More than 20 persons, then ₹300 per person. Also, you need to add 500 toll charges in the total charges. Let's start the program. CLS, input, enter, number of persons. Correct? We can take P for the number of persons. If number of persons less than equal to 3, means up to 3 persons, then charges will be ₹500 per person. So I can write CH equal to 500 asterisk P. Okay, 500 into number of persons. Else if second condition, that is between 4 to 10, I can write P greater than equal to 4 and P less than equal to 10, up to 10 persons, then in that case ₹400 per person. So I have to write CH equal to 400 asterisk P. Okay, third condition, else if number of persons greater than equal to 11 and number of persons less than equal to 20, between 11 to 20, then it will be 350 per person. So I have to write charges equal to 350 asterisk P. And the last condition I will write in else, that is more than 20. So I can directly write CH is equal to 300 asterisk P, means ₹300 per person. Then end if. Now, after that, we have to add 500 toll charges in the total charges. Okay, so I can simply write CH is equal to CH plus 500. And we need to print the charges. So write print charges is equal to CH and then close the program by writing end. Let's run the program. The number of persons, I am going to enter 5. So it should be 5 into 400, 2000. Plus extra 500, 2500, correct? Question number 6. Write a program in QBasic to accept the number of years for which any insurance is to be purchased, then calculate the insurance cost as per the following rules. Number of years and cost per year. So, I can see that the question is given in form of first 2 years, next 2 years, next 4 years, above 8 years. Remember, whenever the words first, next, above are used, that means in this type of condition, you have to calculate the value which will include the previous values also. Means you have to first make the condition range. That means first 2 years will be 1 to 2. Then next 2 years will be 3 to 4. Then next 4 years will be 5 to 8. Above 8 years will be greater than 8. Now any calculation you will do in any of the condition, that will also include the calculation of the previous conditions. Okay? How you will understand that? By reading the words first, next, next, above. Only if these words are used, first, next and above, then only you have to do like this. And if these words are not used, then it is a normal conditional program. Let's start the program. CLS, input, enter, number of years. We can represent the number of years by Y. Then if Y is less than equal to 2, means up to 2 years, then it is 1 lakh per year. We can write IC for insurance cost. IC is equal to, I can write the formula 1 lakh asterisk Y. Remember, whenever you are writing a program and you are mentioning any amount, you should not give any comma although the commas will be given in the question, like it is given there 1,01,00,000, but when you will write the program, you will remove the commas. Okay, so if the number of years are less than equal to 2, means for the first 2 years it will be 1 lakh per year. Else if, second condition, if the number of years greater than 2 and number of years less than equal to 4, means 3 to 4, between 3 to 4, then IC is equal to, now for the number of years which are exceeding 2, the cost is 90,000. But for the first 2 years, the cost is 1 lakh per year, correct? So you need to write like this in this kind of program, Y minus 2 asterisk 90,000. Okay, means for the number of years which are exceeding 2, means more than 2 years, for that I will use the current condition, which is 90,000 per year. And the 2 years which you have subtracted, minus 2, the first 2 years, that will be 1 lakh per year. So I have to write 1 lakh asterisk 2, means that 2 years that you have subtracted, that is to be calculated separately by writing 1 lakh into 2, because there are 2 years. And for the number of years which are exceeding 2, like 3rd and 4th year, for that I have 90,000 per year. Now how this is working, suppose the number of years are 3, then the first condition will be false, because 3 is not less than equal to 2. It will go to the second condition is true, because 3 is greater than 2 and 3 is less than equal to 4. So it cannot be simply like 3 into 90,000, no. It will be Y minus 2 into 90,000, means 3 minus 2, 1, 1 into 90,000 plus 1 lakh into 2. So it will be 2,90,000. Understood? 2 lakh for the first 2 years, 1 lakh into 2, and the 1 year which is exceeding, the 3rd year, for that it will be into 90,000. That is how we do this kind of program whenever the question has the word first, next and above. Third condition, else if number of years greater than 4, means it is starting from 5, and number of years less than equal to 8, up to 8th year, then IC, insurance cost. Now it is exceeding how many years? It is exceeding 4 years. So I will have to write Y minus 4. That is the trick to remember. There you see it is written Y greater than 2. So I wrote Y minus 2. Here it is written Y greater than 4 in the condition, so I will write Y minus 4, it is exceeding 4 year. Now when it is exceeding 4 year, for the extra years, I will use the current condition, the current value, which is 65,000 per year. Plus, I subtracted 4 years. So for those 4 years, there are first 2 years and there are next 2 years. So for the first 2 years, it will be 1 lakh into 2. I can write that. 1 lakh into 2 plus the next 2 years it will be 90,000 into 2. Okay. Now else, I don't need to write the last condition. Never write the last condition. Write else. Else means what? Else means if it is above 8 year, correct? Now for the above 8 year, it is 50,000 per year. So I will have to write IC, it is exceeding 8 years, correct? So Y minus 8, current charges 50,000 per year. So Y minus 8 into 50,000, and the 8 year that I have subtracted, that includes the first 2 years, the next 2 years and the next 4 years. For the first 2 years it will be 1 lakh into 2. For the next 2 years it will be 90,000 into 2. And for the next 4 years, it will be 65,000 into 4. Okay. The number of years which are exceeding 8 year is 50,000 per year. And the 8 years which I have subtracted includes the first 2 year, the next 2 year and the next 4 year. 4 plus 2 plus 2, 8. Okay. Now, print the insurance cost. Insurance cost is equal to IC and then end. My program is complete. Let's run the program. It is asking into number of years. I am entering 10 years. The insurance cost will be 7,40,000. Question number 7. Write a program in QBasic to accept the number of months for which any house is to be rented. Then calculate the total house rent as per the following conditions. Now here in this question also we have first, next, 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 above. So it will be like the previous question, okay? First 3 months, 15,000 per month. Next 3 months, 12,000 per month. 6 month after that, 10,000 per month, and next 12 months, 9,000 per month. Last one, above 24 months, above charges plus 10% extra per month after 24 month. So the last condition I will be explaining properly. First, let me start the program. We will make the conditions first. First 3 month will be 1, 2, 3. Next 3 months will be 4 to 6. Next 6 months will be 7 to 12. Next 12 months will be 13 to 24. Above 24 months will be greater than 24. Okay. Let's begin with the program. CLS. We need to take input the number of months. So input number of months. We write M for the number of months. Now if the number of months less than equal to 3, first 3 months, then it is 15,000 per month. I can write rent. So I am writing R for rent. R is equal to 15,000 asterisk M, okay, 15,000 into number of months. Else if, the second condition, if the number of months greater than 3 and number of months less than equal to 6, then it is 12,000 per month for the number of months which are exceeding 3. So I have to write R is equal to M minus 3, means the number of months which are exceeding 3 into 12,000 plus the 3 months you have subtracted, the first 3 is 15,000 into 3. Okay, 15,000 into 3. The third condition, else if the number of months are greater than 6, means starting from 7, and number of months less than equal to 12, then in that case we have to first calculate for the number of months which are exceeding 6. So we have to write M minus 6. M minus 6 into the current rate, which is 10,000 per month, plus the 6 months you have subtracted includes the first 3 and the next 3. So the first 3 is 15,000 into 3. The next 3 is 12,000 into 3. Okay, the third condition is done. Now coming to the fourth condition, else if, that is next 12 month, means starting from 13, okay, starting from 13, else if number of months greater than 12 and number of months less than equal to 24, in that condition we have the rent is equal to 9,500 per month for the number of months which are exceeding 12. So R equal to M minus 12 exceeding 12 into 9,500. Now the 12 months that I have subtracted includes the first 3, the next 3 and the next 6 that I have to calculate manually. So first 3 is 15,000 into 3 plus the next 3 will be 12,000 into 3. Then the next 6 will be 10,000 into 6. Okay. Now, else, last is above 24 months. Okay. In above 24 months, we have above charges plus 10% extra per month after 24 months. That is the condition given. Okay. So, in the else part, I have to first calculate for the above charges. Above charges means first 3, next 3, next 6 and next 12. So that I will calculate by writing. First 3 is 15,000 into 3. Correct? Next 3 will be 12,000 into 3 plus. Next 6 will be 10,000 into 6. Next 12 will be 9,500 into 12. Now by writing this, I have calculated the above charges. Now for the number of months which are exceeding 24, I have to take 10% extra per month. Okay, now 10% extra of what? 10% extra of the above charges. So if I say the above charges I have calculated in the variable R it is stored. So 10% of R I need to calculate per month. Take one more variable R2 is equal to total number of months minus 24. By writing this you will get the number of months which are exceeding 24. Means the extra months. Correct? Into you need to do 10% of the value of R. Okay, R is the above charges and 10% of that. You can simply write 0.10 into R and we are done. Now finally you have to write R is equal to R plus R2. Okay, now what we have done in the variable R, we have stored the above charges. Means the first 3, the next 3, the next 6 and the next 12. Then for the above 24 months, the exceeding charges, for that we have done m minus 24 to know the number of months which are exceeding 24, which we have multiplied with 10% of the total above charges, because 10% of the total above charges per month to be added. Okay, so the exceeding number of months, suppose the total number of months are 26, so 26 minus 24 is 2. For 2 months I have to take 10% extra, so that will become 20% extra. So 10% into 2 it will be. Okay, now R2 is the extra charge plus R is the actual charge. I get the total charge R. Okay, I have stored in the same variable. Then print total house rent is equal to, I print the variable R and let's see the output. It is asking into number of months. If I take 30 months, then this is the rent, 4,08,000. Question number 8. Write a menu based program in QBasic to create a temperature converter. There are 4 cases. Okay, case number 1 is Celsius to Fahrenheit. Case number 2 is Fahrenheit to Celsius. Case number 3 is Kelvin to Celsius. And case number 4 is Kelvin to Fahrenheit. This is a menu based program. So we are going to make it using select case. And in any menu based program, menu is compulsory. That you will create using print statement. For all the 4 conversions, I have written the formula. So we are going to use this formula only. Let's start the program. CLS print number 1 Celsius to Fahrenheit. Print number 2 Fahrenheit to Celsius. Print number 3 Kelvin to Celsius. Print number 4 Kelvin to Fahrenheit. Then write input, enter choice. Okay, so user will get 4 options, either Celsius to Fahrenheit when the choice is 1, then Fahrenheit to Celsius when the choice is 2, then Kelvin to Celsius when the choice is 3, and Kelvin to Fahrenheit when the choice is 4. Let's start. Select case CH, case 1. There we have to write the program of Celsius to Fahrenheit. So we have to take input the temperature in Celsius. We can write input enter temperature in Celsius. Okay. We can take a variable C. Formula is given, F equal to 9 by 5 in bracket multiplied by temperature in Celsius plus 32. Then print temperature in Fahrenheit is equal to F. Okay. Coming to the case 2, that is Fahrenheit to Celsius conversion. So we have to take input the temperature in Fahrenheit, right? Enter temperature in Fahrenheit, variable F. Okay. Formula is given, C equal to 5 divided by 9 into F minus 32. Then print the temperature in Celsius. Temp in C is equal to C. Case number 3. This is Kelvin to Celsius. So we have to take input temperature in Kelvin. Write input enter temperature in Kelvin K. Then formula C equal to K minus 273. Then print the temperature in Celsius. Then write case 4, that is Kelvin to Fahrenheit, input the temperature in Kelvin, okay, formula is F equal to 9 divided by 5 in bracket asterisk K minus 273 bracket plus 32. Then print temperature in Fahrenheit is equal to F. Okay. Then all cases are over. Write case else. Print wrong choice. End select. End. Okay, program is over. Let's see the output. Number 1 Celsius to Fahrenheit, number 2 Fahrenheit to Celsius, number 3 Kelvin to Celsius, number 4 Kelvin to Fahrenheit. Enter choice, I am inputting 2 Fahrenheit to Celsius. Enter temperature in Fahrenheit, I am inputting 100. So in Celsius it will be 37.77778. Question number 9. Write a menu-based program in QBasic to perform the following task. A. Check bus number. B. Check 3-digit palindrome number. Now, what is a bus number? I have given the explanation. A number is bus if it is ending by 7 or it is divisible by 7. Means if at least one of the condition is true, then it is a bus number. For example, 17, 7, 14, 21, and 28. Here you can see 17 is ending by 7, so it is a bus number. 7, 14, 21, 28, these 4 are divisible by 7, so they are bus numbers. Second is 3-digit palindrome number. First, what is a palindrome number? A number whose reverse is same as the actual number is a palindrome number. For example, 111 is a palindrome number. 121 is a palindrome number. 333 is a palindrome number. 55555 is also a palindrome number. Any number whose reverse is same as the actual number is a palindrome number. But here my point is, it should be a 3-digit number also. So these examples which are in front of you, 121, 333 and 767, these examples are 3-digit palindrome number, as they are palindrome and they are of 3 digits. Let's start the program. And in this question, we have the choices A and B. So we have to take input A and B in string format using dollar sign in the variable. CLS print A, check bus number, print B, check 3-digit palindrome number. Input, enter choice A dash B, ch dollar, use a dollar sign with the variable as the choice will be string, select case ch dollar, case A. Now when the choices are string, then your case will have double quote, like case A in double quote, case B in double quote, like that. Okay, because the choices will be strings, A and B are strings. In the case A, I have to check for the bus number. So input any number, input enter any number. Let's take N as the number. So condition will be if N mod 7 is equal to 0 or N mod 10 is equal to 7, then print it is bus number, else print it is not bus number. And if, okay, now the first condition which I have written, N mod 7 is equal to 0, that will check if the number is divisible by 7 or not. Means you divide any number by 7, mod means remainder. So if the remainder is coming 0, means it is divisible by 7. And the second condition is N mod 10 equal to 7. Means if I divide the number N by 10, mod means remainder, the remainder is 7. So if you divide any number by 10, the remainder is the last digit, that is the concept. You can take any number, like you take 97. 97 mod 10, what will come? 7. You take 99, 99 mod 10, what will come? 9. You take 15, 15 mod 10, what will come? 5. You divide any number by 10, the last digit will come out as the remainder. So if the last digit that has come out is equal to 7, means the number is ending by 7. First condition is for divisible by 7. Second condition is for ending by 7, and I have used OR, means any one of the condition is true, then it is a bus number. Moving to the second case, case B. In the case B, we have to check if the number is a 3-digit palindrome number. But first we have to check if it is a 3-digit number or not. Only if it is a 3-digit number, then we will also check if it is a palindrome number or not. Understood? Means if the number is not a 3-digit number, then we will immediately say it is not a 3-digit palindrome number. So first we have to check if it is 3-digit number or not. Only if it is 3-digit number, then only we will also check if it is palindrome number or not. So first have to input a number, input enter any number. I am taking N as the number. First condition will be if N is greater than equal to 100 and N is less than equal to 999, means if the number is between 100 and 999, that means it is a 3-digit number. Now we have to check if it is palindrome or not. For that I have this condition, if N mod 10 is equal to 100, okay, then print 3-digit palindrome number, else print not a 3-digit palindrome number. And if, now what is the logic? The logic is, if the number n mod 10 means last digit, correct? You take any number n, you do mod 10, you'll get the last digit. So if the last digit is equal to n slash 100, what it will give me? It will give me the first digit. N slash 100 will give me the first digit. You take any 3-digit number. Suppose the number is 530. 530 divided by 100, what will come? 5. 690 you take. 690 divided by 100, what will come? 6. 123 divided by 100, what will come? 1. You divide any number by 100, if it is a 3-digit number, it will give you the first digit as the quotient. So we are using integer to keep the whole number only. This part will give you the first digit and this part will give you the last digit. So if the last digit is equal to the first digit, then it is a 3-digit palindrome number. Else it is not a 3-digit palindrome number. But we have closed the end if, that is for the inner if. The outer if is still open. In the outer we have to write not a 3-digit palindrome number. Understood? Means if the number is not between 100 and 999, then it will directly go to else and it will print not a 3-digit palindrome number. Means I don't have to check if it is palindrome or not first. We have to check if it is 3-digit or not. Now if it is a 3-digit number, then this condition will be true. Then we will check if the first digit and the last digit, both the digits are same or not. If the first and last digit both are same, then we can say that it is a 3-digit palindrome number. Now case else after that, here we print wrong choice, then end select, then end. Let's run the program. We'll try both the cases, okay? Let's try case A. Check bus number. I'm taking a number 17. The output is, it is a bus number because it is ending by 7. Let's try again. Case A, enter any number, I am taking 21. It is a bus number because it is divisible by 7. Let's run the program again. This time I will use the case B. So enter any number, I am taking 1221. Remember 1221 is a palindrome number, but it is not a 3-digit number. So output will come not a 3-digit palindrome number. Let's try again, last time. Choice will be B. Enter any number, I am taking 121. It is a 3-digit number as well as it is a palindrome number. Question number 10. This is the last program. Write a menu-based program in QBasic to perform the following task. Number 1. Check if any number is a perfect square number or not. Number 2. To find the greatest digit in a 3-digit number. Now what is a perfect square number? When you square any number, like if you square 3, what you get? 9. So 9 is a perfect square number. Okay? 3 is not a perfect square number, but square of 3, 9, that is a perfect square number. Similarly, if I square 5, what I get? 25. So 25 is a perfect square number. Means a number is perfect square if it is square of any other number. Correct? Now coming to the second question, to find the greatest digit in a 3-digit number. So you will be given a 3-digit number, that can be any number, but it is a 3-digit number. So for example, this is 957. In this number, which is the greatest digit? 9. So that should be printed. Understood? Let's start the program and see how it will be done. CLS print number 1. Check perfect square. Number 2, find greatest digit. Input, enter choice 1 or 2. CH, select case. In the case 1, we will write first input, enter any number. Let's take n for the number. Okay, now how to check if it is perfect square or not? Use this logic. If SQR n is equal to int SQR n, okay, then print perfect square. Else print not perfect square. And if. Now what is the logic? See, SQR is a function, means a predefined program. It is used to find the square root of any number. So the logic is, if you do the square root of any number which is a perfect square number, for example, if you do the square root of 9, will you get a fractional number or you will get a whole number? Think about it. If you do the square root of any perfect square number, for example, square root of 9, square root of 16, square root of 25, square root of 64, so it will be a whole number, correct? So square root of n is a whole number, and int of square root of n, what is int? Int means the whole number part, correct? So both will be same. But if you take any other number, for example, if you take 10, then the square root and the int version of the square root will not be same. I'm showing you in the calculator. See the calculator. If I do the square root of 9, square root of 9 is 3, which is whole number. But if I do the square root of 10, then square root of 10 is 3.16227, understood? So if I do the square root of any number which is a perfect square number, then the integer version of that square root value and the actual square root value will both be same, isn't it? Means square root of 9 is also 9 and integer part of 9 is also 9. So it will print perfect square. But if I try 10, so square root of 10 will be 3.16, this number, and integer part of this number will be 3. So 3 is not equal to 3.162277, okay? In that case, it will print not perfect square number. Coming to the case 2, here we have to find the greatest digit in a 3-digit number. So I'm writing the program, then I will explain you how it is working. So, what I am doing here, first I am inputting a number, okay, that number is n, clear? Now, if the number is greater than equal to 100 and the number is less than equal to 999, that means it is a 3-digit number. Then only I will try to find the greatest digit. Now, if the number is not a 3-digit number, means the number is not between 100 and 999, so it will directly go to else and it will print not a 3-digit number. No need to find any greatest digit, okay? How to find the greatest digit? I have taken a variable g. G stands for greatest digit, okay? Basically, I am taking out all the digits from the number one at a time. So if the number is 957, first I will take out the digit 7, then I will take out the digit 5, then I will take out the digit 9. And I will compare the current digit with the greatest digit I have got, correct, which is by default 0. Now I'll show you how this is working. Just pay attention. Suppose the number is 957. My value of the variable g is 0. I'm writing it here so that you can understand. G is 0, okay, at this moment. And my variable n, means my number, is right now 957, correct? So g is 0. Now, what is the next step written there? Next step is D1 equal to n mod 10. Now, if the number is 957, 957 mod 10 will be 7. So, the value of D1 is equal to 7, correct? Now, what is the condition written there? I have used multiple if. This is one set, this is second, this is third. So, first set is if the D1 is greater than G. What is D1? 7 means the current digit is 7. What is the greatest digit I have got by default? 0. So 7 is greater than 0, correct? So D1 will be assigned as the new greatest. So what will be the new value of the greatest? 7. Understood? Now after that, I have to remove the digit 7 from the number. So I have written this line n equal to int n by 10. What is n? 957. 957 by 10 will be 95.7, and int means integer, means whole number of 95.7 will be 95. So that will go to the variable n. The number will now become 95, means the last digit is removed. After that, the next line is d2 equal to n mod 10. Okay, now what is n? 95 mod 10 will be 5. So d2 is 5. Now the condition is if the second digit, if D2 is greater than G, means 5 is greater than 7, correct? No, this part will not work. Then again remove the digit 5 by this line, n equal to int of n by 10. What is n? 95. 95 by 10 will be 9.5. 9.5 in integer will be 9. So the new number will be 9. After that, n mod 10. What is n? 9. 9 mod 10 will be 9. Remember, whenever the dividend is less than the divisor, then the dividend itself is the remainder. This is a rule we use in programming. So if I say 5 mod 10, remainder is 5. If I say 1 mod 10, remainder is 1. If I say 9 mod 10, remainder is 9. If I say 6 mod 10, remainder is 6. Whenever the dividend is less than the divisor, the dividend itself is the remainder. So if in my case n is 9, what is 9 mod 10? 9 only. So D3 will be 9. Now after that, if D3 is greater than G, what is D3? 9. What is G? 7. So 9 is greater than 7, means till now my greatest digit was 7 and now I got 9. So 9 is greater than 7, correct? So that will go to the variable G. So the variable G will contain now 9 as the greatest digit. My code is complete. Now it will print the greatest digit equal to G. What is G? 9. So 9 is the greatest digit. Now I will write case else. In the case else, I will print wrong choice. Then I will write end select. Then I will write end. Let's run the program. Let's try the case one first. Check for perfect square. I am inputting the number 25. Output is coming perfect square because 25 is a perfect square number. Let's try again. My choice is 1. And internally number, I am typing 17, it is not a perfect square number. So it will print not perfect square, okay? Let's take the case number 2 for the greatest digit. So case 2, I am inputting a number 1, 2, 3, 4. It will print not a 3 digit number, correct? Let's run it last time. Choice is 2. Internally number, I am taking the number 504, okay? Output will come 5 is the greatest digit. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to get new video updates.